Good morning, family of God. Muy buenos días, familia de Dios. Welcome to the Salvation Army. Bienvenidos todos aquí al Ejército de Salvación. We're going to begin our worship service at this time. If you're joining us for the very first time, we welcome you. We hope you feel at home and will want to join with us again. Los que están aquí por primera vez, muy bienvenidos todos. Que sienten en casa, que sienten entre familia para acompañarnos en el futuro. We're going to begin with a prelude. Vamos a comenzar con un preludio. And our prelude for this morning gives us our focus for the theme for today. El preludio va a expresar el tema para el día de hoy. We're in a series from the book of Galatians. Estamos en medio de una serie de temas del libro de Gálatas. And so today we're looking at the fruit of the Spirit. Hoy consideramos el fruto del Espíritu. So give your attention to this video prelude as we begin our worship service. Prestan atención, por favor, a este video que expresa el tema de la mañana, el fruto del Espíritu. Let us pray together. Oremos. Father God, we are gathered in your house with the deepest desire to worship you. Nos reunimos en tu casa esta mañana, Señor, para adorarte de todo corazón. As we reflect on this theme today about the harvest of fruit your Spirit can bear in our lives if we'll just open ourselves to you and obey you and put you the first place in our life, we ask your Spirit to teach us today. Enséñanos, Espíritu Santo, en el día de hoy, cómo tú puedes producir una cosecha de fruto espiritual en nuestra vida cuando te obedecemos, cuando entregamos nuestra vida a tu control. We have worries and concerns and burdens that are on our heart today, God. Somos honestos, Dios, para decirte, tenemos cargas muy pesadas en nuestra vida en el día de hoy. Help us to trust you with those worries, those concerns, those heavy burdens, so we can focus on you and we can hear from your Spirit. Queremos entregarte estas cargas, Dios, para poder enfocarnos en ti y escuchar de tu Espíritu. We dedicate this time to you, to hear from you, and to worship you. In Jesus' name. En el nombre de Jesús, dedicamos esta hora y es la actitud de nuestro corazón para adorarte. Amén. The fruit of the Spirit is what He produces in our lives. El fruto del Espíritu es lo que Él produce en nuestra vida. I don't know how many of you have ever had any experience in the agricultural realm. Maybe have you visited a farm or you've been out in the country or an apple orchard or anything like that. No sé si han tenido experiencia con agricultura, visitando en una granja o visitando una viña o un lugar de producción de fruto. This past week, I was blessed to go with my wife to visit my parents. and my sister and her family in Western Michigan. La semana pasada tuve el privilegio, la bendición, a ir a Michigan a visitar mis papás, mi hermana y su familia. They are in the season right now in West Michigan of harvesting the crop of blueberries. So many varieties of blueberries, and the bushes are full of fruit. And you can go at a place, they call it You Pick, and you can pay for a fee and go in there with a basket and pick as many blueberries as you can. And then they'll weigh it up for you. And I don't know what you pay for a pound of blueberries at the supermarket, but it was like a dollar for a pound of blueberries, which is very discounted. And they're fresh off the bush and so ripe and delicious. And I looked at those blueberries this week, thinking about this morning, and we were going to talk about the fruit of the Spirit. God, if my life is a bush, I want your Spirit to make me fruitful. And what does that look like? That's our concentration today. Fuimos a visitar y los arándanos están en momento de cosecha en el oeste de Michigan. Son azules, esos berries, esos blueberries, deliciosos, dulces y listos, llenos de jugo, perfectos para hacer panqueques, perfectos para hacer muffins, todo lo de sabor de blueberry. Y podemos ir y por un dólar por libra recoger la cosecha de blueberries uno mismo en su propio cesta y llenarla y llevarla a casa para disfrutar. Y viendo los arbustos llenos de arándanos, llenos de esos blueberries, pensando en esta mañana, Dios, haz del arbusto de mi vida una cosecha fructífera de tu espíritu. So our call to worship this morning is another video, this one in Spanish, The Fruit of the Spirit. Este próximo video es nuestro llamado a adoración y es en español y tiene el tema ¿Cuáles son los frutos del Espíritu? Give attention to this video. It's a recapping in Spanish of what we just saw in our prayer. Spirit in our lives. We want to worship God with our singing. Queremos ver el fruto del Espíritu en nuestra vida y queremos adorar a Dios y agradecerlo. We're going to sing a song together, and I invite you to rise with me, put ourselves in a posture of worship, pongámonos en una postura de adoración y cantemos juntos, gracias Dios. Let's sing together, I thank God. Put your hands together, worship Him with all your heart. Usa las palmadas, usa nuestro espíritu para adorarle a nuestro Dios.
Cargado de oscuridad, cargado de oscuridad, cansado estoy, sin amor. Mas no he podido ganar, me estoy echando un pecador. Mas cuando yo llegué a mi fin, Jesús me dio yo a mí y me dio
Libre solo. And we rejoice in that today. Tenemos gozo en el día de hoy. We like to have a time of sharing when we worship together here at Salvation Army. We like to pass the microphone around and give everybody a chance to say, here's what God's doing in my life. Nos gusta pasar el micrófono y dar toda la oportunidad de expresar, eso es lo que Dios está haciendo en mi vida. You can tell us whatever's going on, if it's a burden that you've had lifted, if it's a victory that's been won, or maybe it's a fight for your life that you're in right now. You're in pain, you're struggling, you're grieving, whatever you're going through. If you've got faith in God, tell us about it today, and all of our hearts will be encouraged. Todos podemos cobrar ánimo escuchando los testimonios de los que, aunque están en medio de la batalla, tienen fe en Dios. And maybe you want to even say today something about the fruit of the Spirit of God that you've seen in somebody else to encourage them, or the fruit of the Spirit that you've seen God working in your life, whatever it might be. I want to pass this microphone to whoever has the first testimony. Lalo, okay, God bless you, brother.
Buenos días a todos. Yo quiero darle gracias a Dios porque en esta clase que estamos teniendo en la mañana, la semana pasada, yo estuve batallando, porque usted sabe, pastor, cómo a veces uno está tratando de buscar la dirección de Dios para saber cuál es la lección. Y yo llegó jueves y no tenía nada, ¿verdad? Entonces, en esa noche, oré al Señor que tuviera su dirección. Y a través de un sueño, Él me dio la escritura. Y dijo la escritura de la clase. Y hemos visto cómo en la clase ha bendecido a todos los que participan, especialmente a mí. Y yo le doy gracias a Dios porque es el mayor milagro. Es lo que está haciendo en mi vida a través de las escrituras que compartimos con ustedes. Yo le doy gracias a Dios por eso.
Amén. So that was our Sunday morning Bible teacher, and his testimony this morning is that when he's looking from God for the message, the lesson to teach, he prays about it and asks God for that direction, and the Lord gave him a dream this past couple of weeks about the scriptures to share, that it would do a work in his life, and then also the life of all the students, everybody that comes. And God's been answering that prayer because God's doing that work with his own word in Lalo's life. And the participation of all the students, it tells him that dream, that vision comes from the Lord because it's his word. Amen. Thank you, Lalo, for that. Navo?
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. You know what? I can say this. I had something great happen yesterday. We had a nice little get-together with a lady. She just turned 70. And it was a good thing in life because she was very, very happy. And I can see it in her face. And people around her were very happy, and I just enjoyed myself. And you know, God put us in that place to help each other. He put me on, put me back to work, but you know, that's what I do all the time when I cook. But I can say this: it was a wonderful time. And what I was saying today, I have a lot of faith. My faith now is way beyond the point. And, you know, I know when I have faith like that, I have to give it to the next person. Because that means that person that I be with will feel the same faith that I feel, that God is pushing in me to push to the next person.
Amen.
Amen.
Entonces, Nabo tiene dos testimonios. Uno, que ayer hubo una fiesta de cumpleaños para una persona especial. Se llama Diane Reed. Cumplió 70 años. Y ayer toda la iglesia estaba llena de personas celebrando la vida de una persona muy especial. Y Nabo estaba presente y da gracias a Dios por la vida de su amiga, esa persona muy especial, Diane. Y también está dando gracias a Dios por el crecimiento de su propia fe. Que puede recordar momentos en el pasado cuando no tenía tanta fe, pero ahora tiene mucha fe y fe muy fuerte. Y él dice que Dios está revelando a él que la razón por qué tiene más fe y fe más fuerte es para compartir la fe con otros, que en un momento necesita algo más de fe. Navo is sharing his gift of faith that God has given him to give to others so that their faith will grow as well. Right, Navo? Praise the Lord for that. That's the fruit of the Spirit. Right? I love to hear that. Anybody else have a testimony? Yes, brother.
Buenos dias, la familia.
Wow, buenos dias. Good morning. Okay.
My name is Quinn, you know. About 2-3 weeks ago, I was on a bad car accident with my family. I took that as my way of God trying to get me back on track to break the old cycles.
Yes.
So he can come forth and use me the way he wants to. So that's what I've been working on.
That's little Quentin.
Yeah,
Quentin. Amen. God bless you, Quentin. We're glad that you and your family are here with us today. Dice que hace tres semanas él y su familia estaba en un choque de vehículo, de carro, muy terrible, y él lo tomó como un motivo de Dios en su vida para cambiar el trayectorio de su vida y para buscar los caminos del Señor. Y por eso él está aquí hoy con su esposa, su hijo, su bebé. You're here with your son and your baby daughter and your wife, and we're so glad that you're here, that God protected you in that accident, and that he's using it to put you on his path today. God bless you. Brother David.
Good morning, everybody. I really don't have nothing to say. Really, I just want to say I've been really working on myself, you know, as far as my anger issues, you know, everybody doing, you know, I got a little temper. I've been trying to control it. I've been controlling it since I've been in daybreak, and all, you know, I've been doing it. But I just want everybody to look to the right and the left of each other, tell each other that you love them, and Jesus loves you.
Dile a la persona a tu lado, Dios te ama, Cristo te ama.
I love my church family. I love y'all.
Yeah, I love, bro.
All right. Thank you, David.
I love y'all.
Mucho amor en este lugar. Mucho amor que viene del Señor. God's love is filling this place, and it's giving it for one another. We got another song to sing, and this one says, "Bless the Lord, oh my soul." Otra canción que vamos a cantar dice, "Que todo lo que soy alabe al Señor."
Sound in soul, es su nuevo amor.
Continuamos con esa actitud de adoración. To present to God our tithes and our offerings. Presentamos a Dios nuestros diezmos y ofrendas. The Lord teaches us that all things belong to Him. And whatever we have comes from His hand. He's entrusted it to us to use it to bless our families, to bless our community and one another. And when we give it back to Him, He multiplies it and uses it. Dios tiene control de todo. Él es dueño de todo. Lo que tenemos viene de su mano. Y nuestra parte es regresarle parte de Él, lo que Él nos ha dado, y Él lo bendice y lo multiplica para bendecir a muchos más. Let's pray together before we worship in our tithes and offerings. Oremos. God in heaven, You are worthy of praise and worship by our song, by our prayers, by our testimonies, and by our giving. Tú eres digno, Dios, de alabanza, con nuestro canto, con nuestro testimonio, y con nuestro acto de diezmar y ofrendar. You know the economic circumstance of every person in this room. We ask that You would care for and provide for the needs of each one. Tú, Señor, conoces la situación económica de cada persona y pedimos que Tú provees lo necesario para cada uno. Enhance and grow our faith, God, as we give to You, trusting that what remains will be enough and that You'll use these gifts to bless others. Aumenta nuestra fe, Señor, para saber que lo que nos queda será suficiente y lo que damos Tú vas a multiplicar para bendecir a muchos más. In Jesus' name we pray. In the nombre de Jesús oramos. Amen. During the time that we'll come forward and put our offerings in God's altar, a video is going to play about patience. That's part of the fruit of the Spirit. El video que va a presentar durante la ofrenda será sobre el tema de esperar y ser paciente. The song says, while I am waiting. La canción dice, mientras que estoy esperando, dame paciencia, Señor. Give me patience, Lord, I pray. Come to God's altar with your gifts. Vengan al altar de Dios con nuestras ofrendas.
On you. Lord, though it is painful, but patiently I will wait. I will move ahead, bold and confident, taking every step in obedience while I'm
esperando, te serviré, Dios. Our scripture this morning is from Galatians chapter 5. La lectura bíblica para esta mañana, Gálatas capítulo 5, verse 22, versículo 22. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things there is no law. Galatas 5:22. En cambio, el fruto del Espíritu es amor, alegría, paz, paciencia, amabilidad, bondad, fidelidad, humildad y dominio propio. No hay ley que condene estas cosas. This morning we're focusing on the fruit of the Spirit, patience, kindness, and goodness. Nuestro enfoque de esta mañana es el fruto del Espíritu, paciencia, amabilidad y bondad. Next week we're going to look at the following three, which are gentleness, faithfulness, and self-control. El próximo domingo vamos a considerar fidelidad, humildad, y dominio propio. So thinking this morning about patience, the story that I was reminded of was at camp 2 weeks ago. I was with about 50 children up at our camp in Wisconsin, and we were living in tents, and we were cooking our meals over a fire, and we were learning outdoor survival skills. Hace dos semanas fui con un grupo de 50 niños a nuestro campamento, y estaban dormidos en carpas, preparando comida sobre fogata y aprendiendo cómo sobrevivir en el desierto, sobrevivir en lugar silvestre. ¿Así se dice? And so there on the screen you see on the right hand side is our little sister Anya. And the task at hand was to start a fire without any matches, using flint and steel to make a spark and try to get a fire going. I don't know, has anybody ever tried to do that before? You know about this, is that Alexia? No, Paris. You've done that before or tried? It's not easy. No es fácil prender una fogata sin fósforos, usando nada más una herramienta que produce chispas, y con unas pequeñas chispas poder comenzar a hacer o preparar La Fogata. So there was little Anya and all the other kids around her, and she's making so many sparks, but it just won't start. Anya haciendo muchas chispas, pero la fogata no quiere prender. And you can see how tired she was. She was tired and frustrated, but she was being patient, and she wasn't going to give up. Everybody's like, oh, it'll never start. And Anya's like, no, I'm going to get it. Anya estaba frustrada, no quiso prender la fogata, pero con toda su energía, haciendo chispas y confiando, sí va a prender, sí va a prender. She just knew it was going to start. And so she kept going, and there you can see the flames. Do you see those little flames? Puede ver las llamas, que sí produjo un incendio, un fuego. Un fuego comenzó por sus esfuerzos, porque tenía paciencia. She was patient, and she didn't give up. So part of the fruit of God's Spirit in us is patience, to not give up. Parte del fruto del Espíritu en nosotros es paciencia, de no rendir, sino perseverar con paciencia. I like this movie that's out there. It's about a guy who builds an ark. And it's sort of a modern retelling of the story of Noah. It's called Evan Almighty. I don't know if anybody's ever seen that movie. Si han visto la película Evan Almighty, que cuenta la historia de Noé, pero en el día actual, en el día de hoy. There's a moment in that movie where he and his wife are having this conversation about what's going on in their lives, that their relationship, their family, their future, they've got a lot of stress. And his wife says to him, you know what? When we pray and we ask God for patience, does he just zap us and say, boom, you're patient? No. He gives us chances to be patient. When we say, God, make me courageous, does he go, zoop, now you're brave and courageous? No. He gives us chances to show courage. And it's his Holy Spirit in us that makes that happen. En la historia de Evan Almighty, él y su esposa están conversando acerca de su matrimonio, su familia, la situación de su vida. Y ella pregunta, cuando oramos y pedimos a Dios paciencia, él nos hace, ¡zas! Ya eres paciente. O nos da oportunidad ser paciente. Cuando pedimos valentía, Dios hace, ¡zas! Ahora eres valiente. O Él nos da oportunidad de mostrar valentía. Es su Espíritu en nosotros que produce paciencia, el fruto de su Espíritu. Patience is not simply the ability to wait, it's how we behave while we're waiting. La paciencia no es simplemente esperar, la capacidad de esperar, sino cómo nos comportamos mientras estamos esperando, con paciencia. God's Spirit in us enables us to wait while we obey, wait while we trust, wait while we serve. We've got situations in our life we want God to change, and He's in the process of changing them, and He's in the process of changing us, but He asks us to be patient, and His Spirit produces patience in us. Dios sabe las cosas que necesitamos cambiar en nuestra vida, en nuestra situación, y Él está en proceso de cambiar y transformar, pero pide de nosotros paciencia que Él produce por su Espíritu. The other slide picture says, people think that patience is the ability to wait, but that's not it. Patience is how we behave while we wait. La gente piensa que la paciencia es capacidad de esperar, pero no es así. La paciencia es cómo nos comportamos mientras esperamos. What else does it say, the fruit of the Spirit? It says it's patience, it says it's kindness. El fruto del Espíritu es amabilidad. Amabilidad. One definition of kindness is loaning someone your strength instead of reminding them of their weakness. Wow. All day long, we could point out to people, that's where you're weak, that's where you're messing up, that's where you can't do it. That's not kindness. Kindness is saying, God, give me strength so I can come alongside and share that strength with somebody else. La amabilidad no es mirar las vidas de muchos más y pensar, ellos son un fracaso, ellos no pueden superar, ellos no tienen nada. En vez de prestar atención a la debilidad de otros, es buscar fuerza de Dios para prestar esa fuerza a nuestro prójimo. That's being kind. La amabilidad como manifestación de respeto y consideración es dar valor a la otra persona. Kindness as a show of respect and consideration is giving value to the other person. Everyone is created in the image of God and they have innate value and worth. And we owe it to them to show them kindness. We know that intellectually I need to be kind, but how do I get that kindness? It's God's spirit in me. Yo sé que debo demostrar amabilidad a mi prójimo, pero ¿dónde encuentro esa amabilidad? Porque en mí mismo, en mi carne, soy muy apto y muy rápido a criticar. Pero por el Espíritu de Dios en mí, Él produce amabilidad que puedo demostrar a los demás. What the life of the Spirit, we were talking about this in the Bible class this morning, the life of the Spirit is responding to His prompting, His direction, His voice in our life. So we say, God, I'm going to get up this morning, show me a chance today, God, to be kind, and then help me to do it. Cada mañana, orar a Dios, Dios, dame oportunidad hoy ser amable, demostrar amabilidad, y Dios provee en mi vida esa amabilidad para compartir. And the third aspect of the fruit of the Spirit for today is goodness. We know that only God is good. The scripture tells us over and over, the best thing we can produce is like a hamper full of dirty clothes in comparison to the perfect holiness and goodness of God. La Biblia nos enseña que solo Dios es bueno. Solo Dios expresa y tiene bondad en su identidad. Lo mejor que podemos hacer es como ropa sucia delante de la perfección de la bondad de Dios. Pero Él produce por su Espíritu su bondad en nosotros. There's a difference between just being kind and the goodness in action. Hay una diferencia entre benignidad y bondad activa. Bondad activa poniendo en acción la bondad que hemos aprendido de Dios, de cómo Él es con nosotros, hacer lo mismo con nuestro prójimo. As God has been good toward us, to be good toward others. Another way of saying goodness is love in action. One of the aspects of the fruit of the Spirit, the first one is love. Love, joy, peace, love. Love in action is goodness. El amor en acción es bondad. I will never forget the kindness and the goodness of a lady that I worked with once. This is now more than 20 years ago, but if I close my eyes, I can picture her face, and if I concentrate on it, I can remember her words, how she showed kindness and goodness to me. I was passed over for a promotion at work that I really wanted and I really thought I was qualified for. En mi vida yo tenía la experiencia en un trabajo que yo tenía de solicitar una promoción. Yo pensé que era calificado, que yo era la persona adecuada para la promoción y no recibí la promoción. The owner of the business that I was a part of, he promoted somebody else. And he said to me, here's what I need in my deputy assistant, the person to come and be my assistant director. And you don't have it. El director de la compañía me dijo, voy a promocionar a otra persona porque mi asistente, era el trabajo de ser su asistente, su mano derecha. Y él dijo, necesito a alguien que tiene tal capacidad y tú no tienes esa capacidad. I felt so broken and disappointed and disillusioned and hurt. But there was another person in our organization who came to me and said, you know what? I was on the committee. And I thought you were the one. And I'm sorry you didn't get that promotion. But you know what? I have a connection with another organization where you would be a perfect fit. And if you want, I'll write you a letter of reference, a letter of recommendation. I'll come and be your advocate for you.
Esa persona era parte de la organización, era parte del comité. Y ella dijo, mi voto era para ti. Otros votaron diferente y el director eligió otra persona. Pero yo tengo conexiones en otro negocio y yo puedo escribirte una carta de referencia y ser tu abogada por parte de la otra organización donde tú puedes pertenecer y ser la persona adecuada. How is it now, more than 20 years later, that I remember her and her kindness and her goodness to me on my behalf? She didn't have to do that. She was under no obligation to do that. But she showed me that kindness and she demonstrated that goodness in it. I never forgot. Nunca he olvidado esa conversación, su amabilidad, su bondad para tratarme de esa forma. So what I want to say to you is that this week, ask God, give me an opportunity to show kindness. Give me an opportunity to demonstrate your goodness to somebody that needs it. El desafío para ti es pedir a Dios esta semana, Dios, dame una oportunidad, ser amable. Dame una oportunidad de mostrar tu bondad a una persona que se necesita. You actually have a very practical way to do that right after this service. We're going to conclude in just a few minutes. And as was mentioned in Novel's testimony, there was a huge party here yesterday. And if you look in the gym, you'll see that some of the remains of that party are still there. And tomorrow we've got our food pantry, and tomorrow our day camp kids are here. You've got a chance to show patience and kindness and goodness if you would help us gather up some balloons, push some carts of chairs, sweep some floor. Is that too much to ask in God's house that the people of God would say, we're going to come together and make things ready for those day camp kids tomorrow and for that food pantry? Una oportunidad muy práctica vamos a tener. Concluimos este servicio muy pronto. Antes de irse, estamos pidiendo que el pueblo de Dios se trabaja juntos para limpiar. El gimnasio está un poco deteriorado por el evento de ayer y mañana tenemos la despensa. Casi 200 familias que van a necesitar comida. Y mañana los niños vienen para el day camp y necesitan el espacio preparado. Es mucho pedir a la familia de Dios buscar una escoba y trabajar un poco, mover unas sillas, unas mesas. Es una oportunidad de mostrar amabilidad, bondad y paciencia. It's an opportunity to show kindness and grace, kindness and goodness and patience. I want to invite you to think about doing that. You've got another opportunity coming up on Saturday. It's the annual Family Fun Fest in downtown Joliet, right across the street from the Rialto Theater. There's going to be live music and vendors and attractions and fun. And the Salvation Army Canteen is going to be right there. Our mobile kitchen is going to be there. And we need some volunteers to help pass out some information about Salvation Army, pass out some school supplies, pass out some treats. And say to the community, your Salvation Army is here. You can show kindness and goodness and patience in that setting this coming Saturday evening from 5:30 to 6:30. Linda is going on a trip that she has been planning for and is going to enjoy, so she's not going to be there. Linda is our rock star of volunteerism, and she's going on a trip that she deserves, so we're going to step up. And she's not going to have to worry about, oh, what's going to happen on Saturday when I'm not there. Because the people of God are going to handle it. Right, Linda?
Yeah.
Linda va de unas vacaciones que merece y no va a estar presente el sábado cuando hay un festival en el centro de Joliet. Mucha música, actividad para familias. Y en medio de todo, la cocina móvil del Ejército de Salvación, nuestro camión de comida. Y vamos a estar ahí sirviendo. Necesitamos voluntarios. Sábado a 5:30 a 11:30 de la noche, necesitamos voluntarios. Y demostrar a la comunidad bondad, amabilidad, el fruto del Espíritu. That's our challenge. Are you ready? It's like Mission Impossible. Your mission, should you choose to accept it? Are you ready to accept it? Es como la misión imposible. Tu misión, si lo aceptas, será tal. The fruit of the Spirit. Let God's Spirit be at work in your life. deje que el Espíritu de Dios está activo en tu vida. So our time of reflection and response is a beautiful song. It says, open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see your fruit in my life, God. Help me with a vision of what a fruitful life of patience, of kindness and goodness could be like in my life. La canción dice, abre mis ojos, oh Cristo, para verte. Para ver el fruto de tu espíritu en mi vida. Dame una visión, oh Dios, de cómo es vivir como un cristiano amable, paciente y bueno. Let's worship God. Let's pray to Him. Let's come to His altar and ask for His fruit in our lives. Whatever it needs, you need to say to God today, use these moments to say it. Usa estos momentos para decir a Dios lo que necesitas decirlo. Puede venir aquí al altar de Dios para orar o donde está sentado. Abre mis ojos, oh Cristo. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. I want to see you. Let's worship, let's respond. Adoremos a Dios y respondamos a su Espíritu. Good to be together this morning. Ha sido muy bueno estar juntos en esta mañana. So we're going to move from this place to the gym, to the lobby, to do some work together. So tomorrow when the day campers come, everything's ready. Mañana vienen los niños para el programa de day camp. También tenemos la despensa mañana por la tarde. We've got the food pantry tomorrow. On Tuesday and Thursday evening, we're offering conversations about mental health, so that everybody in the community can have the resources, the encouragement, and the information that they need. Los martes y jueves por la noche estamos conversando sobre el tema de salud mental y ofreciendo ánimo y recursos para el bienestar de toda la comunidad. Wednesday morning, we have a chance at 10 o'clock for women's ministry. If you're interested, let us know, and we can have that time of Bible reading and prayer and worship and encouragement with one another. Tenemos el Ministerio Femenino miércoles a las 10. Next Saturday is the last day for KB Hoops for this summer, and next Sunday they're going to have their awards banquet in the afternoon. It's been a wonderful summer with those kids. Keep praying for them, that God would bless them. Sigue orando por los niños en el programa de basketball. Este sábado será su último programa, y el domingo tendrán un picnic, un almuerzo de celebración para el fin del campamento. And next Sunday morning at 10 o'clock, come and meet with Brother Lalo as he gives our Bible lesson. El domingo a las 10 están todos invitados para la clase bíblica que Lalo nos está compartiendo y el Espíritu de Dios nos está enseñando. God's Spirit is teaching us during that hour. You won't want to miss it. It'll be beautiful. And then next Sunday, we've got our next theme from our Fruit of the Spirit. And then in 2 weeks, our theme of those who belong to Christ. El próximo domingo, el fruto del Espíritu, otro aspecto, y en 2 semanas, un tema sobre los que pertenecen a Cristo. In 3 weeks, we've got August 13th, that's our back-to-school blessing. Invite all your friends and neighbors and other students from your school, and let's have a back-to-school blessing. En 3 semanas, invite a todos los amigos, vecinos, parientes, y buscamos una bendición especial para el inicio del año escolar. In a month from now, we've got at Camp Wonderland in Wisconsin, the North and Central Illinois Division gathering. It's the welcome for our new bishops, we call them divisional commanders, our new archbishop, or we call her our territorial commander, she's going to be there, and then some special guests from our national headquarters. It's going to be a beautiful weekend, and be in prayer for everyone that will be gathered. En un mes será un campamento, un retiro familiar. Bienvenida a los nuevos líderes divisionales y territoriales y unos invitados especiales del cuartel nacional que van a estar también un tiempo muy especial. I'm going to ask Lalo again if he would give our closing prayer and we'll conclude our time together. Lalo va a ofrecer la oración de clausura y luego tenemos la limpieza para hacer.
Let's pray. Vamos a orar. Señor, te damos gracias por habernos dado la oportunidad de alabar tu nombre. Gracias, Señor, por las bendiciones que tú nos diste. Y Señor, en este día pedimos que tú nos ayudes en esta semana que viene, que tu presencia esté con nosotros, Señor, y que nos ayudes en todas las cosas que enfrentemos, que podamos ser un reflejo de tu amor y de tu paz y de tu presencia, Señor. Father, we thank you for the opportunity you give us today to come and worship you. Thank you, Lord, for the blessing that you have given us throughout the week. And we pray, Lord, that as we continue to live this coming week, that your presence may be with us and help us, Lord, and the challenges and the things that we're going to encounter this week. And allow us, Lord, to show the light of your Spirit through our lives. Give us your blessing as we go our way. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.